come back, everyone. The deputy mayor and councilor for the St. Anne's Bay division host a conference at the St. Anne's Bay Primary School in St. Anne, Jamaica. Some of the guest speakers were the previous mayor, Michael Belnavis, who quoted in his speech that when he was mayor, he was the godfather for the St. Anne's Bay division. Some of the comrades who disagreed and renounced that, Councilor Dalas Dickenson and Deputy Mayor, he is the godfather for the St. Anne's Bay division. Here we have it.
Dalas Dickenson is here to make it five-time sound. Because he has been around from 1997.
Real.
A long time. He has been serving the people of St. Anne's Bay since 1997. He has been a candidate and a victorious candidate for the Jamaica Labour Party.
Oh, man.
He has showed you what victory is all about. He has showed you what it is to have good representation. He has shown you what it is to go up there and sweat and toil for the Jamaica Labour Party.
Make them know!
People of St. Anne's Bay Labour Rights. So let me hear you for Dalas, Councilor Dalas, Deputy Mayor Dalas Dickenson. As you know, I'm the godfather for Northeast Center. From a long time ago. As a matter of fact, I see a lot of old-time laborers right here, a lot of faces. Lot of faces. Right? Lot of faces. From Upper Windsor Heights, from the Magoli Road, right through Ghetto, all about. Right? Everybody knew me. Right? That is the godfather. When I step out and come back to Northeast Center, when Shahidi called me and said, "Why you control both of us?" I guess he's saying that people like that. But I am here to tell you.
The second speaker was Geneva Garden Bailey, councillor for the Lymore Division in St. Anne, Jamaica. She spoke in her speech that Ocherius will have the biggest health center and the family will not be hungry anymore because they have a star boy who is known to be Matthew Samuda, who will be running as MP in the next general
What?
is only for greater days. For still town, your clinic was rehabilitating. Centers Bay, the clinic, the health center, the greatest health center in Jamaica will be built in Ocho Rios. And we know, say, with part-term loading, Christopher Tufton will be cutting the ribbon for those prosperity mission going forward. A few months ago, while we were in the wilderness and worried about what would be our next chance for Northeast Central. As you know, we don't want to make no mistake in letting PNP think that they have an angle in Northeast Central. We now have one of the best young politicians. In spite of what all of you may think, he was a shining star long time in our books. But Satan now, with all of them pretty girls, young and old, we will be taking care of him to make sure that Naughty Satan, Matthew Samora, Mr. Samora, the last 3 months have been like Naughty Satan. The last 3 months, Naughty Satan has felt what they have been feeling for years. The family is back together, and we see some little imposters walking around saying that they know that they are going to win Naughty Satan. Hello, hello. Little whoever they are, this will never happen. As long as we are alive, Labour Party will always be in Naughty Satan. Matthew Samora, our future going forward.
I've been a long time.
So, my colleague Councilor, my party, Dalas Dickenson.
One done.
He said, Saturdays ago, everybody give me the trophy and the crown to the conference in Northeast kickoff. Hey. Not true. But you know, a sentence there, and to be free of some of my people, you take off the crown and put it on the men.
The third speaker at the conference was none other than the Minister of Health, Dr. Christopher Tufton, who were given his comrades the strategy on how to have them remain in power, that of which they had to do to keep them in power. Here we have it.
Go through them phases of disagreement. But at the end of the day, if you touch one neighbor right, you're supposed to touch all labor rights. We have to band together as one labor party to ensure that we take the next election when it calls, whether it's local or it's general. Because at the end of the day, we can work together, and we will work together. We have the best man leading Jamaica at this time, Andrew Wallace. We have the best candidate for the next local election in St. Anne's Bay Division, Dalas Dickenson, and you have the best candidate being put forward to run Northeast Central. One more you want. We just need to come together and ensure that it works for all of us. So we have the plan, we have the people, and we have Shaini energy behind us, in front of us, over us, guiding us, labor rights. That is the winning formula. Make sure it happen. God bless you. Love the Labour Party. Love your brothers. Love your sisters. And let us work together, JLP, central, local government, to carry Jamaica forward and improve the lives of you and your family. Shout out to all
of you. The fourth speaker was none other than Dr. Nigel Clark, the Minister of Finance, who spoke vibrantly that Jamaica is experiencing the best macroeconomic fundamental of any time in the last 50 years. He also elaborate on employment and also spoke about what had happened during COVID. That COVID has caused a massive shock to our nation and to the world on a whole. But during COVID, over 150,000 persons within the labor force had lost their job. And at that time, the unemployment rate was at 10%. And he had worked tremendously to bring down that percentage to 4.5%, where all 150,000 or even more than 150,000 persons from the labor force had acquired their jobs once again. He also states that we must fulfill our macroeconomic before we can have the microeconomic dealt with. Here are the details.
A man who was led and had the conviction to tell the Jamaican people exactly as it is. Now, under this Andrew Michael Holness government, this Jamaica Labour Party government, Jamaica is experiencing the best macroeconomic fundamentals of any time in the last 50 years. You hear what I said? I said, under this Jamaica Labour Party administration, when Andrew Holness as Prime Minister, Jamaica is experiencing economic fundamentals that exceed what has ever been in place over the last 50 years. You know, we live in a climatic zone where economic will show that we economically have recovered from the COVID-19 economic shock in a time period that we have never seen before. Unemployment went up, and as you quit your eye, unemployment came back down to the lowest levels in our history. 4.5% from the COVID highs when it was 10%. 150,000 people got back them down. In addition to that, the value of what all of us produce on an annual basis, the gross domestic product, GDP, for the quarter ending December 22 was bigger than the quarter ending December 19. In other words, we are producing more per quarter than we did prior to the COVID-19 pandemic. Now, there are quite a few countries that can say that. But no country in the Western Hemisphere, there are nearly 30 countries in the Western Hemisphere, and no country in the Western Hemisphere, with the exception of probably Guyana, can say those two things, plus our debt is lower than pre-COVID. So we have recovered output, we have recovered employment, and we have done that without putting Jamaicans in debt. Jamaica stands tall in the world as a result of these achievements. And there's some who don't want you to know that. In addition to that,
our foreign exchange reserves as an island. We don't make US dollars, but we need to import things. So our reserves are important, because what our reserves say to the outside world is that you can sell goods to Jamaica because they have the money to pay you for it. Jamaica have the money to pay you for your goods. So you can import on Amazon if you want. I don't have to worry about it.
Amen.
Because we have more reserves in our central bank than at any time in our history. Despite COVID, when this government took over in 2016, reserves were $2 billion. Everybody say $2
billion.
$2
billion. $2
billion. So, we have the highest reserves in our history. We have the lowest unemployment in our history. And our debt is the lowest that it has been for 25 years. Now, those are things we have to protect with everything that we have. There's some who want you to believe that the macro don't matter. But I'm here to tell you that that is what we thought for 50 years in the wilderness with high unemployment, high inflation, and low growth and high debt. For the micro to thrive, we need the macro to be stable.
Welcome everyone, and thank you for being here once more and listening to the vibrancy of information that need to be received and need to add air to, so that we can resort to making the right decisions in making our country, our beloved country, Jamaica, great again. As it is said, and you have listened to the various speakers of that night of the event, when we look at health centers within our parish of St. Anne, making a bigger health center in Ocherius is not impossible. But we have the biggest health center in St. Anne's Bay currently. And I'm saying to myself, why won't we utilize the space that we have to create a more effective workspace for our workers? Giving them better payment so that they can perform effective services. When you go to the health centers, no matter where it is located, within the parish or outside of the parish, it's an entire day of wait. It's like you have to tell yourself, I'm going to take my house with me, a part of my house with me, which most importantly will be the kitchen. Or you just have to be that patient to say that I just want to get this over with, because I don't have the subsidy or the liquidity to go to a private mat or a private practitioner. As it relates to hunger, everyone face hunger on a daily basis. And we might be here getting a chunk change from our families, from overseas, a friend here or there. Many of our people who borrow money don't borrow it to do business. Sometimes they have to truly borrow for vacation and truly borrow to put some food into their houses. Some borrow to pay their partners. Some borrow to pay their bills, outstanding bills, because they don't want to use their utilities. So why is it that we're looking at productivity in our country, where the money we earn is not sufficient to balance the basic necessities of life? Yet there is productivity with a guy. You are the Jamaicans who are feeling the pain from left to right. Some borrow to build houses. When are we going to come to recognition to stop borrowing money to build houses? Have we ever asked ourselves the question, why do we have to borrow as a citizen of a country that provides a positive service, a legal service to any business establishment, whether it is for private men or whether it is for the government? Why is it that we cannot save our money and by the end of the year we have enough to pay for a land, to buy a car, or even to start a house if you already have the land? Our salary deprives us that access because we have been belittled and denied access to a better life and to renounce that we are the true Jamaicans. Everyone is seeking that opportunity of a farm work or some hotel program in leaving the island. Where is the productivity when half the nation teachers have resigned and seeking jobs elsewhere or took the iron bird to another man's nation to develop their economy for their livelihood and their own sustainability? In the health centers, we have persons who resign their jobs too. There are many other places where people have resigned. They have given up on a job that they were compassionate about. But because of the terror and terror that they have to face on a daily basis, and the deprivation with their salary, if they should get an increase, it is like $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, or perhaps a $7,000, in which will be taxed. And every time workers in the public sector or in the private sector get a raise, the price on goods and services are never yet stabilized. So sometimes I question, why do we read the budget when there is no stable pricing on goods and services throughout the years that we are providing our labor? You go to the supermarket this week, you get paid, fortnightly you get paid, or monthly you get paid, the prices are gone up. And your salary remains the same. We look at the old idea today of the raise in transport. We're looking at the increase in transportation from point A to B, wherever you want to go or wherever you need to be. There is an increase in taxi and bus fares. That extra that you have to find as citizens within this country, where does it come from? Where do you get it from? What productivity that you have that can sustain the rise in public transportation? Some of us have children, more than one. Some of us are paying rent. Some of us have to join partners with our friends, with our co-workers, with our community members, even with the banks, with the hope that you can save something aside, put away some emergency cash. Because all of us has a future endeavor. We have a livelihood to sustain. We have an imagery that we portray, and that needs maintenance. arguing the point of employment, Dr. Nigel Clark quoted that there is provision for employment for everyone. So we're encouraging Jamaicans to become employees, that they work for little of nothing and keep trying and keep trying for a lifetime to survive and turn to the loan brewers to borrow. We are not encouraging innovators. A lot of people have thoughts and ideas in their minds in creating ideas that may become products, and products that can bring capital to our beloved island. We have heard about the roads, the completions, and the continuous creations of roads, the expansion of roads, and all of these things. Taxpayers' money doing these roads. Our factories are closed down. There's no more building being built by the government. No factories or no other buildings being built by the government that will provide jobs for who are leaving high school coming June, July of next year, 2024. The students are in a position in their high schools and at the university level and college level, planning that there will be a way for them coming 2024. And they are studying very hard to make that way clear so that they can have provisions in their life, stabilities in becoming financially stable. Because everyone wants to be able to work honestly for what they need in life. Everyone need that break to say that I don't have to think of trying to get a passport and trying to get a visa for another island unless I'm going to take vacation. And the big question is painted in each of our Jamaican citizens' face today, whether you are a diehard laborite, a diehard PMP, or just a regular worldian. The big question is painted in our faces, and the question is, when will all Jamaicans be able to satisfactory work legally in our country and acquire the amount of money to travel to another country just for vacation and not to work in another man's country? That's the big question. When will we be able to say that no matter what job I do in Jamaica, if I'm picking up garbage from the roadside or from people's gates within the communities, when my time come around on the calendar for my vacation, I can say I can go to a small island, I can go to America, I can go to Canada with what I have worked for. Coming back to the country that we solely love, to say that yes, big up Jamaica, I love Jamaica, and there's nowhere better than yard. When will you be able to say that? When you'll be able to say that, my fellow Jamaicans, that no matter the class of work you do, when that vacation time comes, you can say, hallelujah, I am going to America to spend my vacation with the interest that you'll be getting paid in the bank just the same. Now let's talk about productivity once again. A lot of young men, and especially the young men, are working within the supermarkets, And every day you see them pushing out these trolleys, load with goods taken to the different destinations where they ought to be, where these customers are able to tip them something. These supermarkets don't carry insurance for them. And the salary they get, if they should have a back pain or any muscle strain, once they go to a private doctor, guaranteed the money they work for that week is exhausted just to see the doctor. And guess what? They haven't filled the prescription just yet. What insurance is guaranteed with these young men and women working within these organizations, within these supermarkets, or these merchants? It is important. So when we look at productivity in our country, we must look at these areas. Minimum wage will never be satisfactory because it is something that is termed within the entire Caribbean to belittle the heart, body, mind, and soul of God's chosen people who labor in vain sometimes, but labor, positive labor, to make a difference for themselves, their family, their friends, and to make a difference in their communities. What will happen then? And what will happen now? As we have seen it, and as we have heard it, you are a Jamaican, and you are listening to this. So am I. Diarted you are, or diarted you're not. The provision for our country is to see it great again. To see what our life works are worth, and also for what our foreparents have fought for each and every one of us to be free. And when we look at the conference, all of these people there, they go to church, they work very hard in the labor force. They do. Wow. And reliance on government. We need them. And most of us chose them. We appreciate their effort. But we must know what we truly need as individuals and what is best and in the best interest of our Jamaican country. And each and every one of us know what is right from wrong. So we must do what is right. And stop telling yourself you're serving God when you truly don't know what it is that you're serving. Thank you very much. God bless you and keep you safe. Catch you later.